Autocrafters, your source for Cougar, Falcon, Fairlane, Full-Size, Mustang, Maverick, Pinto, Ford Truck. Contact us at www.autocrafters.com.
Okay, so we've created a thing. Well, we had guys write into us and ask us why I don't like Granada spindles. It's not that I don't like Granada spindles. I really like Granada spindles, but only in the right spot. Mm-hmm. Now, you're kind of young into this, so it's not going to mean a lot to you, but the differences here are pretty extreme, other than the fact that, obviously this is a disc brake spindle because of the mounting positions on it, and this is a drum brake spindle because we showed you those last week. Mm-hmm. But there's a ton of different things on here that just make this a completely different animal and an unsuitable animal in this form for your Ranchero or a 66 Mustang, 65 Mustang, Comet. You get the idea. Anything of those smaller body cars, 1965 on back to 63, 64, and 66 on back on Mustang, this is not a good spindle because of some of the things I'm going to go over here in a second. One of the immediate things I wanted to talk about, though, is the relationship of the different parts on here that make it somewhat problematic to put on an early car. Now, these are called spindles, steering knuckles, whatever you want to call them. Those are the two names that are most used in the hobby. I call them spindles. Some guy call them knuckles. I don't know why, because it does not look like a knuckle to me. But in any case, these are different. And the reason they are different is in 1969, Ford was doing a lot of Trans Am racing, and they were having some problems, I think, with the spindles not performing up to snuff. So what they did is they went in and started beefing everything on their disc brake spindle up. Everything got a little bit bigger and beefier. Yeah. In 1970, they went to a larger bearing set. If you put this on here and then come over here.
Big difference.
Big difference. Do the same thing on the front bearing.
This one's shorter too.
Yeah, it's a little shorter. That was pretty much the same though. That really didn't change that much. It's just a little harder to do because of the... I'll put on the bearing rod here. But you'll notice that both bearing sets are different in size. And I think that had a lot to do with the fact that they were running stickier tires. They were also running bigger wheels and tires on the cars than they were in the previous years. The biggest thing you could get on a 68 Mustang was a 14-inch wheel with a 70 series tire. In 69, the Boss 302 went to a 15-inch wheel with a 60 series tire. Much bigger, fatter profile. Yeah. And I think they started breaking stuff. And so Ford decided to go with a bigger spindle, especially on the disc brake packages. Yep. In 1970. This really didn't happen until 1970. And so when that changed, they changed a number of different things on the spindle. These work exceptionally well on 1966 to 71 Fairlanes. These spindles, because of a couple things I'm going to go over here in a second, really make a nice spindle for that model of car. Now, one of those changes that you can see immediately on the Granada spindle, and I honestly am not sure if that happened on the 69 spindle, but you'll notice that there is a kick to the upper part of this. That is to aid in caster. Now,
what's caster? I don't know what that is.
All right, imagine a shopping cart. Notice you go to the shopping mall or wherever and you get a shopping cart and they've got the wheels kicked out in the front. It's actually centered up where the leg is back here and the center of your wheel is out here. Mm-hmm. That's caster. It aids in the car tracking well and correctly going down the road. Ford didn't put a lot of caster in the earlier cars. Zero caster on almost everything, even the power steering cars, which made them really light in the loafers going down the road. It was easy to turn because most of the time they didn't have power steering. So when you start putting big tires on there, you want a little bit of caster in it, and that's what this spindle tries to do. It adds just a little bit of caster to the front end because of the way it does not run straight up the center line like you'll notice this one does.
Yeah.
You know, your spindle and everything is in a straight line. This one, it kicks off a little bit. That's one of the advantages to this spindle, and in particular if you're running, like I said, it's 1966 to 71 Fairlane. 68 on up Mustang would work just as well, but it is really a better setup for the Fairlane because the Granada chassis is very similar to, but not like, the 66 to 71. Where you get into a real problem with these spindles is when you're dealing with a 1965 Falcon on back or a 1966 Mustang on back. Mm-hmm. Not suited at all. And a lot of that has to do with the relationship of your tie rod position to the back of the spindle. And I want to take these down, turn them around so that we can see what I'm talking about with that. Okay, so I've turned these around and I've set them up in a very unscientific manner. But I wanted to show you what I'm talking about. The problem you run into when you're running the Granada spindles on an early car, like I said, anything, let's just say anything Mustang Falcon 66 back. If I say 66 back, we're talking about 65 Falcon and 66 Mustang, because the 66 Mustang ran this spindle as well. If you look at the Granada spindles, you'll notice that the tie rod sits further back on it than it does on the early Mustang spindle.
Yep.
And Falcon spindle. If you try to run these on a car, your tie rods will not allow for enough toe adjustment. And what toe is when you're looking at the car and it's sitting straight on, this is like from sort of an overhead, you want to put about a 16th of an inch of toe into the car when you're driving it. So the tires need to point toward a center point, not straight out. If you run them straight out, a lot of times a car will want to wander and hunt with radial tires. It doesn't like a zero toe. It prefers about a 16th of an inch of toe. And some of that's also because of a looser, older chassis. It just makes the car track a little bit better. But the problem is if you put the correct short outer tie rod in with the 65 Falcon and the 65.6 Mustang drag link in there, you can't get enough adjustment out of it. Mm-hmm. To get toe the way you should have it. So that's one other disadvantage to this setup, is that the toe is not going to do what you want it to do. You're not going to be able to get that 16th of an inch of toe with the Granada spindle. There are other littler things that are kind of problematic in my mind. One big thing too is this uses a 1970 on up outer tie rod end, which is fine. So if you wanted to put this on a car that has the, you know, the 65 Mustang stuff, you have to get a sleeve for this. Mm. They're available, like Mustang Steve and a couple of other places have these available so that you can sleeve this out to get the tie rod from the earlier tie rod to fit in there, but you still have the adjustment issue.
Yeah.
Now, moving on from there, being marginally even, like in other words, we're sitting these to where they're sitting flat. They're different on the side profile as well, which tells you that the mounting position of the tie rods on here are different. In other words, they don't sit in the same spot. I believe that the tie rod for the Granada spindle is actually lower, so it's lower and inside. Because if you look at it, the angles are pretty dramatically different, even with this kick in it. This one sits a little more in than this one does. So you have a difference in that as well. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and talk about the spindle positioning here. And just show on a profile shot that these sit a little bit differently, even so, with the upper part of your ball joint. All right, now, what I'm going to talk about is the relationship difference between the verticalness of this spindle and the slight angle that this spindle has. What that deals with is camber, and basically camber is, if you're looking at your tires from straight on, it's the tires being in. See, you're learning. Holy crap.
I knew that.
Okay, well, that's what camber is, and some of that's basically involved here. I got these as vertical as I possibly could so that we can see the difference in the camber. What it boils down to for me is I don't think the handling geometry on this spindle on an early car is as good, mostly because of the relationship of the center line of the actual spindle stack here to the end of the tie rod, because it's completely different on the Granada than it is on the early Falcon. It's gonna jack with your handling. You're not gonna be as happy with the way the car tracks down the road. You're picking up the advantage of a beefier spindle, but you're losing that advantage in the fact that you won't like driving it, because the car will always feel a little bit skatey if you can get the front end to align. And it will also feel like it's just really light. It's like it doesn't feel like it's going to want to track correctly. Bump steer is more of an issue with these spindles because it takes all the advantages that they pulled in 1965 on the Falcon and also on the Mustang and pulls them right out because of a difference in your tie rod position. This sucker right here is where your problem is. There is a solution to that, and we'll go over that when we seal this thing up near the very end. But what I wanted to do now is kind of discombobulate what we've got going on here, and then we'll put a control arm, an early control arm, on both of these to see if their spindle holes are going to be the same for the control arms. Okay, now, I've pulled everything out, and we've got the spindle sitting. This is our disc brake spindle. This is our original spindle. And basically, on looking at it and checking out, this is an upper ball joint that will, you know, bolt right in here. And it's fine. It'll work on this one. It will work on this one. Lower control arms. This is an original 65-6 lower control arm for Mustang and Falcon. Nice and tight.
Yep.
And we'll go in here. And it'll fit nice and tight, so there's no walk to it. The only place you're going to have a problem is, like I said, with the tie rod ends down here. Now, what I wanted to talk about next on this is that our spindles here are a little bit different in as far as length from our tie rod end to the center point of your lower ball joint. Now, the center of this one, this is all rough too. We're like 7.5 to center here. And then on this one, we're at like 7 to center. So you're picking up 0.5 inch of distance on this one that you don't have on this spindle. Mm-hmm. And that's really where your problems come in. So what it really does is it boils down to your steering not being as good. Okay, so if we put these on your car, it won't handle well. Because of the tie rod difference, because this is just completely different than this is. All right, something I wanted to talk about on this is one of the things that people will bring up is the fact that on these spindles, you can't run the original 14-inch wheels from a Falcon or a Mustang, 1966 on back. And that's because the wheels were just a lot different because the hub size was smaller on those early cars, and the hub size on these is larger post-1969. You have a difference in the outside diameter of your main hub. And with that bigger difference, you have a larger opening there, so you have to have the later model wheels to make that work. In my opinion, that's not a big deal because even aftermarket wheels that look just like their styled steels from 1965, 66 on the Mustang, guess what? They have the larger openings in them.
Yep.
That's not the big problem. And then the other problem that people will talk about in this is the calipers striking the back of the wheel on those original wheels. Again, it's an issue, but it's not a huge issue because if you go with the aftermarket wheels like I'm talking about, you won't have that problem. So that's the one thing I wanted to mention on that. I think that's not a huge deal. It's not a deal breaker on the Granada spindles. Yeah. The bigger deal breaker, as I said before, is a tie rod end setup. But there is something that is out there now. There's a place that sells spindles for the early cars that are based off the Granada stuff. Okay. So in other words, it's a Granada spindle with all the advantages of the Granada with the bigger bearing lines and all that. And, you know, it's a good beefy spindle. But the tie rod setup has been modified to suit a 65-6 Mustang or early Falcon. So you can run a Granada spindle. If yours are trashed out, you have the option now of being able to go in and get an early set of these from the guys over at Auto Crafters because they do carry this spindle and they also carry the drag link for the Falcons, yeah, and for the Mustangs. And then you also can go to the guys at CRSP and get a set of the Granada spindles for, like if your car has Granada spindles on it already. Mm-hmm. Like, so let's say we bought the Ranchero.
Yeah.
And it had these, the old style Granada spindles on it. You could go in and replace just the spindle with the guys at CRSP and fix all the front end problems that it's exhibiting with the Granada spindles, with the new spindles that they sell, because all of your brake components will bolt right up. Mm-hmm. Now, the other thing I'll say about Granada spindles, and this is the part that's the bigger issue now, is finding a set of these.
Yeah.
Not in the reproduction stuff, but an original set of these spindles, they used to be a dime a dozen in the salvage yards, and now anytime you walk up on a Granada in the salvage yards, these are missing. So these are really hard to find, and these are really hard to find out there in the world. Fortunately, the aftermarket has come around, and they're making correct Granada spindles, which will be good on a Fairlane. They're also making a version of this that will work on a 65-6 Mustang or 63.5 to 1965 Falcon, mm-hmm, Comet, whatever. So there is a solution to the problem. It's just not a cheap solution. Yeah. This used to be supposedly a cheap way to get disc brakes on a car, on an early car. Because disc brakes back in the, I know you don't know this, but disc brakes used not to be a thing. Up until probably 1970, 71, disc brakes were an option deal. In other words, they weren't a standard package thing. Maybe on up into the early 80s, you didn't get disc brakes as a standard item on a classic Ford. Mm. They got more and more popular because of the stopping power that they offered and the lack of fade that they gave that you would have a problem with a drum brake.
Yeah.
But they weren't all that. So when guys wanted to do performance, your only choice was to find a 68 to 71 Fairlane. Mm-hmm. Or Falcon or Mustang with disc brakes on it and rob the spindles off of it, which was the same problem you would still have on an earlier car. Or you did the Mustang conversion, like stainless steel brake makes a kit that'll allow you to put disc brakes on this spindle. So you, one of those two things had to happen. And before stainless steel brakes came around, you had to find a GT Mustang or Fairlane with the disc brakes on it and rob the brake kit off of it. All right, folks, well, that's our show for this week on Manic Mechanic. Hopefully this gives you an idea what you need to be looking for and avoiding, in some respects, the Granada spindle on an early Mustang or Falcon. But come back and watch us next time and see what we're up to right here on Manic Mechanic.